Hey guys, well, I decided to do another electronics vlog. I got some more parts in for the computer. The issue I have with this Cooler Master case, I don't know if you can catch that if I move back and forth. Right here, and right here in the acrylic, there is actually a crease. I don't know if that's from heat damage or what. Like I said, I did say when I originally did the build, it looked like this thing was in a hot warehouse or something. And the acrylic did not look good. The only reason I really never noticed this defect here is because this part here was in the back and I had the button panel here, so it was turned this way. I ended up turning the light out inside because it was catching my eye every time I sat down. It was just driving me up the wall, so I decided to get a case with tempered glass at the same price. It's the Cougar MX330G, so that just came in, and I ended up grabbing, since I made the leads on the power supply that I just rebuilt really short, I ended up picking up some PSU extension cables in white. We'll see how that turns out. But the other issue I have, besides the defects in the case, is I never realized how much I missed a ROM. A lot of my software is still backed up on CD from back in the day. Plus my wife likes to play Diablo 2, and she was asking about that the other day, and obviously I can't play it because there's no place for the ROM to go in this case, which I didn't really think it through. I actually tried taking the board out of an external drive to plug into the RAM, and it didn't. It would come up in Windows, but it wouldn't display the CD-ROM icon. So, guessing the firmware on the board on that only supports like a hard drive and not the ROM. So, I gave up on that. I got like six of these things downstairs, all working. I figured instead of buying an external CD-ROM to go on this case, I'd just basically get a new case because it's. Like I said, it's got defects anyway. We'll probably reuse this downstairs. I was looking to put that little HP server in something smaller. If it'll fit in here, I'll put it in here because it'll lighten it up a bit. This thing weighs a ton. And it's only got a single drive in it right now anyway, so this will probably work out pretty good as a little server. But anyway, let's take it downstairs and start ripping this thing down. Well, here we are back at it. I figured this would give me something to do since we're all in lockdown anyway. You know, besides the fact that there's massive creases in this plexiglass, or what do you want to call it, Lexan or whatever it is. I just cleaned it once with a paper towel just to get rid of some of the dust, and it literally scratched the minute I touched it. So I'll never get acrylic again. But like I said, I'm hoping... if the board in this HP, this 200 pound HP, isn't too heavy, I'll probably put that in this, because right now that's only running on my bench with one hard drive, and that's pretty much all I need in here, maybe an SSD, and that'll save me from lugging that thing again. That thing weighs a ton. It's not even a joke, it's so heavy. So I might be able to get the board in this. But anyway, the one that I ordered is here. It's pretty much the same price. Only difference is I paid, but I think $10 more for the tempered glass. Well, right off the bat, just taking it out of the box, which I had to do because of COVID. I like it. Nice tinted glass. It's got it's like machine screws, thumb screws. Nice. Those threads, though, look a little thin. You gotta be careful over tightening those. Snap them right off. But I'm not gonna spend too much time in this anyway. I wanna be able to set it up where I have enough room to put my. I'm thinking to put the water cooler on the top, only because it's the same size as my rad. Oh my god, that is so nice. That is way better than acrylic. Let's put this somewhere in a safe place. Yeah, that's not the safest place. Oh well. I like it that it has this. It's not as thin as people were letting off it was. Wow, that's nice. It would be even better, you know, for how much it would have cost them to do it, like a couple of pennies to put the little rubber grommets in here. Anyway, like, that would even make it even better. A better selling point is just to add the little rubber doodads in there. They didn't. Comes with a nice, cheap, floppy fan. Ugh, that fan is terrible. Where the hell we got that? I should have enough room in here to get my one ROM in here, and I like it that they don't have an actual bracket here. You just mount it here and here, and then that should be it. Like I said, the top is the right size for my rad, so I'm guessing that's where my rad's going to go. We'll just have two RGB fans here, two SSDs, and I think there's room in the bottom here. We'll just turn it around here for my 5.5 inch or 3.5 inch, whatever you want to call it, hard drives, the old type mechanical. Yeah, you can go down there. It leaves lots of room for my power supply. The hard drive cages are flimsy as always. Looks like they're bent to just putting it together. Nice long leads. I'm not really going to do a review on this case, only because there's like a million of them on YouTube now, even in different languages, so I don't see the point. What you do is you type in MX330G and there's like 50,000 videos. There's your USB 3. All our power connectors reset, and I'm thinking these are the USB 2. And HD audio. Cool. Flimsy hard drive trays. Actually, I have enough. It's still under there or not. When I took the server apart, I took this bracket out that was in the bottom of that. I did a mod on. I may be able to fit it in here and still have the power supply. I have enough room for four if I wanted. It comes with an extra case blank. A couple of tie wraps and screws and stuff. I don't know if there'll be enough screws in there to mount the fans. There's a few long ones in there. What else? That's about it. Well, it's not as flimsy as they let off being. Some people were saying it's pretty flimsy. I've seen worse. Now that kind of sucked that you can't take that out. It's all riveted in, so you'd have to basically pop the rivets out to get it out. And there's a massive gap in the front here that you could literally put the rad right to the case and then put the fans on the inside past this shroud. Anyway, let's get the filter for the top. Let's get the other case in here and start ripping it down. It's going to take a while. I'm doing it the right way. Yeah, like I said, this isn't a bad case. I just didn't do my research. And the acrylic having the warp in it is what did it for me. I never noticed it because this was turned that way. But once I put this power button on the bottom instead of the side, you could see it. And I disabled the light inside of it because I couldn't stand looking at it anymore. I don't know if you can see it now. Put it up to the light. Yeah, you can barely see it, but there is creases in it. And scratches like crazy already. Oh well. New supply, power supply works excellent. I actually tried doing something. I don't know if it's going to damage my board or what. But when I was working on this PSU, I noticed each rail, the 12 volts, the 5 volts, and the 3 volts rail, has a shunt And then there's a trace that goes to the chip inside the power supply. And I don't know if that adjusts the current or it detects the current and shuts it down. Anyway, I put a little bit of butter or a little bit of solder on each shunt. Maybe it'll give me a little bit more amperage, like over what it's recommended. All I know is when I put this in compared to the 500, 550 watt, this computer is totally different. It's it muscles through everything. Any game I put up, it doesn't lag or stutter that it was doing before. Like it was acting like it was a lack of RAM. It was only 8 gigs of RAM. I should have at least 16, but it doesn't even do that now. I mean, I load any games and it just fires right up. So anyway, stop talking and start ripping this thing apart. Oh, I also got the braided ATX sleeve cables. We'll get into that in a minute. I'll try out my new screwdriver. Know if that's the right size or not. Bigger the better. There. Don't need a real fine one. I'll just end up mucking it up. One thing I do like about this is that this has a magnet in there. It keeps it from falling out, unlike that one there. Where do we start? I do remember I have to loosen this off to get this out. One thing I do want to do, though, before I want to take the cooler right off and have it separate so I can set the board in. I like to do it at once, but I don't want things dangling around. Just ground ourselves here. Alright, let's go. Yeah, the only thing that's going to be an eyesore is that. Unfortunately, they have a black one available. And everything else is working. Yeah, these screws here are too big for that screwdriver. I mean, a legitimate screwdriver. This video card has been working flawlessly. I love it. It's funny though, because I only paid two and change for it, and now it's up way past $300, which is a bit of a joke. It's amazing how the prices go right up. Okay, let's get the cooler out of here. You can see how well our paste did. I'm gonna put it down. Oh, that's pretty good. Definitely spread out. Out of the way. I'm gonna be very careful. The last thing I need is that spring a leak. Which everybody I talk to is like, I don't do water cooling anymore because they leak and blah blah blah. I'm like, okay. You're making me a little nervous. So I'll keep an eye on it anyway. I've already stress tested the hell out of it with a couple of games. This screwdriver does a really good job with the screws on the board. Obviously, you don't super torque those. The back part came off. Ooh. Come on. Oh, that one's not going to move. Yeah, I'm going to do another video, see if I can mod this this case to fit the HP. That should be fun. I missed one? I think I did. Why am I not seeing it? Well, seriously, where is it? No, oh, there isn't. That's weird. Board is out. Now set the board on top of the acrylic. Oh, scratch. Fans. Oh, wait. Let's do the cooler before that gets smashed. Yeah. So, as of today, Ontario, Canada, is in somewhat of a lockdown. But it's not, they're not specific on what type it is. It's basically, you know, they're just saying stay home, but if you have to go out, kind of thing. They're not like locking you in your house and nailing your door shut yet. Well, we did get a little bit of dust on this rat already. Not bad. And we're gonna have to open the back. I got a fan hub in the back, which I have to unplug everything. Alright, let's move this to a safe location. The chair. Good enough. I know a lot of people are probably saying, oh, I just wish this would end. This is going to go on for a while, guys. A couple of years at least. It's not going to be over by summer. I can't believe when people get on TV and they go, oh, yeah, it'll be over by this summer and blah, blah, blah. Like, really? Come on. What's the matter with you? You got all these different different types of different versions of the virus popping up. Still waiting for the one that turns everybody into zombies. This is the hub I picked up. I never did a video on it. It's cheap. But it does the trick. I never pulled the 3M off the back and stuck it to the case. Obviously, I wasn't happy with it, so I didn't go forward with finishing it off. And the shield, this time I gotta make sure these tabs are bent over. They're all bent in, and when I went to put the board in, it, half of these pins were sticking in a USB port, but I shorted it out. The other thing I didn't like about this case was this power supply adapter. Makes it a pain, it only goes only one way. Would have been nice if they designed it where the PSU could have just bolted up to the back of the case. Why they didn't do it, I don't know why. this one's already stripped out. Yep. Jesus, I barely used it. I like over tightened it. I'm lazy. Trying to get this done as quickly as possible. I'm gonna take my time when I build the new one, or put the parts in the new case. Because that's its final resting place. I don't think I'm going to get another case. Not without building another computer, anyway. Alright, that bracket stays in there with the mod. And we got to take the back off of this. Okay, I think we're done. Oh, we got one more fan to go, and then we'll get started on the new one. Clean up hard drive out of here, so damage it. Power supply should just come out. Okay, the light will take out eventually. I'm in no hurry for that. SSD can come out. All right, I think we're done. I don't think anything else we need on that. We'll throw that together later. I'm gonna take my product serial number off of that case as well for Windows 10. This is going to be a long video, guys. I'm not going to lie. I got nothing better to do. Like I said, we're in lockdown. I don't mind doing it. Alright, let's get the new case up here and get her set up. Oh, the other reason I got this case is I want to do mod where I'm going to end up Dremeling this out. Putting a little LCD in here that shows displays the different parameters of the board and everything else. So that could be kind of cool. But I couldn't do that with that one, obviously. Too tight. Check this fan out. I'm feeling it's just the cheapest fan money could buy, obviously, because it's the cheapest case money could buy. Could save money somewhere. Even the paint job on this case isn't too bad. It's got a sort of hammered metal finish that doesn't scratch easy. Yeah, this fan isn't anything special. Feels like it could break it just taking it out of the case. A lot of play in that baby. Let's do the fans last. Let's get the PSU in this thing and get started mounting everything. Now, I think we're going to go with fan down. Yeah, that'll work. The last time I did a lot of work on computers was at CompuTrade.ca in Hamilton, Ontario. Mainboards have changed quite a bit since then. And that was back in the Pentium days with the slot load Pentiums and everything else. And Windows 98, Windows Me. Okay, let's do the board. Check the drop. Oh, the shield. This time we bent all those pins back so they're not binding. Our board, which I can say has been nice. I haven't had any problems with this board whatsoever. Haven't had to flash it or anything. And I'm going to have to move these. Those things are tight in there. I know what tool I need to get these out, but I'm too lazy to do it. Go grab it. See, the way I look at it is when I finish this build, like I said, I'll have enough room for the LCD mod. But also what I want to do is my RGB skull. I want to be able to make room where I can set in the corner here on the inside of the case versus on the outside where I have to keep cleaning it. Plus it'll look kind of cool. It'll go with the case. I was looking at their higher end cases for high $199 with the handles and that on it, but I didn't like the fact that they put their name on the case in big yellow orange letters. So pass on that. Make sure these babies are tight, because if they're not, when you go to take your board out and you over tighten the screws, they turn out with it. That is a pain in the butt. Let's see. We're almost there. I'm hoping they have two more, because we had to put two more in there. Just when you go to push on the board to plug in the power supply cable and everything else, you need these extra grommets to keep it from bending the board and bottoming it out. There we go. gotta love these cheap cases. Nothing fits. Holy crap. I'll edit this out. Or speed it up, one or the other. I gotta be able to fit this whole video on this SD card because I have no computer to dump this to. Well, I mean, I could dump it to that one, but now it's just gonna make it more of a pain in the butt to transfer everything over. Let everything line up. There's still missing one there, but let's double check that. Make sure there is one there, and it's in the wrong spot. Probably a good thing I checked that. That probably would have shorted the board out, and that would have sucked. This is why you gotta double check these. Hear my arm cracking? That's what happens when you're doing 50 mph and you get hit by a car on your bike. Alright. Not to mention the pain that you feel every day from it. We won't get into that. Yeah, that should be alright. Yeah, I don't know why. I thought there would be more room in this this case. I thought this board was pretty small. Not as small as I thought it was. Oh, that don't feel right. Back up. Thank you. Which ones are what here? These ones might be a little bit small. Nope, those really small ones are the ones for the board. It's weird. And one more. Yep. Well, this is how far I've got. It's been a learning process. I've never used extension for with the combs. I find it be easier if you put the combs on before you install the cables, which I'm finding. But the combs are working, straightening them out. I might put another one down there and fix this up a bit. Had no problems with them. The only problem I had was they advertised as this type of rad, this size, fitting in this case, but I guess they didn't make up for the fact that if you use a CD-ROM that you're going to have some problems. Okay, so it fits up here if you don't have the fans on the inside because it'll hit the fans because they'll hit right about here. So I figured, well, let's put it down here. And right to the... I probably could cut it out here if I had to. But then I'd be going into the hard drive area. But if I wanted to put the rad down here, I wouldn't fit either because it hits the... it's about an inch off and it's too tight. So it won't fit down there either. The only way I can get it to fit without modifying anything is to mount the rad without the fans up and then have the fans mounted up here. I'll have to drill a hole around here somewhere where I can fish the wire down and just pull the air out the top. Doesn't look that weird. Looks more industrial than anything. It's going to look kind of cool with the RGB with the side lights on. But there's no way you can put the fans in the bottom there. I think what I'll do is I have a spare one here. Yeah, I have some spare deep cool fans. What I'll do is I'll add an extra one here in the corner and do a push-pull kind of configuration where it's pulling and pushing out just to help it out. But that is literally the only way it's going to work. I mean, this isn't really much of a filter anyway, so you know, it's go like that. Don't really care. As long as it pulls the air out, the heat out of the case, yeah, I don't really care. All the cabling is done. I still got to set up the hub for the all the fans and tuck the wire away. It should work. Let's do a little bit more work and then I'll bring it back. Okay, well, like I showed you, I had to put the fans up there. Actually, I made it nice and neat now. I had to use tin snips, and I just cut a couple of these little round doodads out of the case so I can run the wires through the bottom down here and to the hub. And pretty much made it nice and neat on the back there, which should be all right. This is basically what it looks like. Nothing too fancy. I got to put more combs in it and, you know, tuck in more wires. But it's nice and clean. This one here has got to be fixed. Just the way I like it. If anything, what I'll do is I got some wrap. I might put a small piece just here just to cover this up. So at least it's all black. But yeah, it'll work. Like I said, I had to put this on the top. And I really didn't want to do it. But there is no room. So what I did is I put another fan pushing out. And so it's a push-pull. And these two are pulling out. This one's pushing in to help cool it because there's nothing over here. And the ROM sort of overlaps the rad anyway, so it's not going to help with cooling. That's it. I'm just about to check everything out before I just quickly power it up just to see if it'll actually work. Okay, we're ready to fire it up. Turned on. Oh, it's blue light. I had no idea that was blue. Listen, there's labels centered on that fan. Good place for it. But, wouldn't say it's pulling a lot of air. Well, we can always change the speed of these. That's pulling in, and these are pulling in, and these two are pulling in, and this one's pulling out. So it should be more than enough cooling. It looks pretty good. Everything's powering up. Cool. Hopefully the OS works. I still gotta plug that in. After all the trouble I went through, I must make sure I plug that in. Well, there you go. The only eyesore I see right now is just this, the ROM. But like I said, I'll put a piece of fiber wrap or whatever over that. It looked pretty good. It turned out better than expected, considering it's such a bargain case. I didn't mind cutting a little hole in the top here to put the wires through for the fans, which they're fine. They can stay there for now, down the road if I decide to remove the ROM, which I probably won't. I would put them on the inside and use the filter. I'll keep the filter. So down the road, I'll probably cut this out here in the metal and put an LCD in there. I should be able to fit it behind the hard drive and then run the HDMI cable up to plug it in for the display. And this is pretty much what it looks like. I'm not going to bother using the case lights. I like it dark. Like I said, that push-pull fan, that extra fan that came with the Rabar Blue for deep cool. But this one's pushing in, these two are pushing in, and these are pushing out. So it should keep it cool. We'll see. Hopefully we can just take it upstairs and plug it in and it works. And we're done. I fired it up. Didn't give me any issues whatsoever. All the cables, all the extension cables are nice and tight. They weren't flimsy or falling apart or anything. Yeah, worked pretty good. I'm just gonna do some tests to make sure this is pulling some air through the top pretty good. Can't really tell if this side's pulling more because of the push-pull setup, but we'll find out. It looks pretty good out the front. You can see, down the road I could probably move the fans on the other side, would make them look even better than through the grill. And what else? The LED lights on the case aren't very flattering, that's for sure. It's just your basic LEDs. At least they made this one blue. Like I said, I'll cover the CD-ROM up with some wrap just to disguise it. I can do some research on the LCD and then cut that out down there. It's not a bad case for the price. And I'll never go with acrylic again due to the fact that it scratches way too easy. So I'm just going to give it a try here and see what happens. One thing I forgot to check, if I had a working ROM, I went through all the trouble. And we do. Sweet. One last look. Those extension cables turned out really nice. I'm going to add some more white stuff in there to even them out. And like I said, I want to cover that up. Later, guys.